Hello students of class 11, hope you are doing well. So this is another video for BSTD, and in this video we will talk about some parts of, as you can see in the board, public, private and global enterprises, right? Now in the previous video I have talked about the features of departmental undertaking, and the next video I have talked about the features of statutory corporations. Now today in this video we will talk about the features of government company. Okay, so please look through the video. Okay, so now first of all we will talk about in the features of government company, basis of formation. Okay, so the first point will be basis of formation. Okay, so what is the basis of formation? Now as you know, the government companies are formed under the Indian Companies Act, okay, in the form of private company also or in the form of public company also. So we can say that government companies, government companies are formed under the Indian Companies Act, okay, in the form of you can say private company or you can say public company. Okay, now if I talk about the ownership, okay, the ownership, let me write it down first. Okay, let me adjust it somewhat. Yes. So if I talk about ownership, now what happens in case of ownership of government company, these government companies are formed under wholly or partly ownership of the government. Okay, so while the entire share capital of a company is held by the government, we call it a wholly owned company. On the other hand, if government hold 51% or more or less than 100% of the paid up share capital of the company, then we say partly owned government company. So we can say that government companies are either partly or you can say wholly by government. Okay, when entire share of capital is held by the government, we call it wholly owned government company. Wholly owned government company. Okay, in the same way, if the government holds, suppose 51% or we can say less than 100%, okay, of the paid up share capital of a company, share capital of a, you can say shared capital of a company. Okay, not have much space here. Okay. I'm rubbing this part, okay. So when 51% or you can say less than 100% of the paid up share capital, 51% capital of a company is held by government, then we called it what? Partly owned government company, okay? Partly owned government company, okay? Then if I talk about the control, as the government is the majority shareholders of this, you can say government company, the absolute power to control of the company lies in the hand of government. Okay, so if I talk about control, so you can say majority shareholders of this government company, of a government company, or write in this way, government is the majority shareholders of the government company, so absolute power of control of the company, you can say, is in the hand of government, is in the government, okay. Then if I talk about the management, now the government companies are managed by the you can say board of directors, by the who are being nominated by government and other shareholders. In case of partly owned government company, most of the directors are being nominated by government. On the other hand, all the directors of a wholly owned government company are appointed by, you can say, the government. So if I talk about management, so management, for suppose if I write in this way, for partly owned government companies, okay, most of the, you can say, directors are nominated by government. Okay, and if I talk about, say, wholly owned government company, they are appointed by the government. They are appointed, the management is being done by the employee who are appointed by the government. Okay?
They are appointed by the government. Now if I talk about the legal status, okay, so like you can say like any other other companies, a government has a separate legal entity. So it can, you can say buy and sell property and
enter into an agreement in its own name. Okay, so legal status. So like other company, a government has also a separate legal entity. Okay, separate legal entity. So obviously it can buy and you can say sell property and enter into an agreement in his own name and enter into agreement in its own name. Okay, now if I talk about the status of the employee, the appointed and service condition of the employee of the government companies are independently decided by the government, but in spite of that they are not regarded as government employee. They are company's own employee. Okay, for the partly owned company, you can say. Okay, government employee companies. So status of employees. Okay, status of employees. You can say the appointment and service condition of the employees of, you can say, government company are independently decided by the government. But what happens, in spite of that, you can write this point, in spite of that, some of them are not regarded as government employees. All of them are not regarded as government employees. Okay,
as government employees. Okay, now so these are the features of government employees, government companies. Some more features are there. This video is getting too long, so I will not explain all of those things in this video. In the next video we will discuss. Okay, thank you.